If transaction lines aren't correct or need to be rearranged, you can add new lines, delete a line you no longer need, or move lines to another location. I'm going to go up to the top left and click plus new and choose invoice. I'll choose one of my customers and I'm going to add some lines to the table in this invoice. I'm going to start with some solar panels. I fill in the quantity and I choose the class. Then I'm going to add an inverter. I'll use the 4K. I add the quantity and again the class. I'm also going to add a backup battery. And finally, I'm going to add installation. Now I'm going to scroll down a little bit so I can see the entire table. Let's start by adding a subtotal to the rows in this table. And the way you do that is to click the button Add Subtotal. And when you do that, it just adds it to the next row. And I want this subtotal to represent products. So I really want it to be above the installation services. To move it, I'm going to point at the waffle in that row. And when I see the four-headed arrow, I can drag up. And when the dark line is where I want that subtotal to be, I let go of the mouse and it moves the subtotal. If you want to add additional lines, you add them at the bottom. I'm going to add some more batteries, but these are the rechargeable kind. Well, I've added that line, but I really want that to be above the subtotal because that's a product. So again, I'm going to point at the waffle, and when I see the four-headed arrow, I can drag it and drop it above the subtotal. Let's say some time has passed and the customer says that they don't want the rechargeable batteries after all. So you want to delete that line, you go over to the right side, click the trash can, and that row disappears. And that's how you work with rows in transaction tables. These techniques work in other transactions like checks, bills, and sales receipts.